We've completed the fireworks geometry nodes in the previous video. For this final step, I will be reorganizing argument list and providing examples of shell designs. During the tutorial, I didn't arrange the parameters in specific order. I want to reorganize them using panels, so when I show you shell examples, you will have less trouble identifying where each parameters are. First, add three panels. Call the first panel Shell Settings. The second panel, Tail Settings. Last panel, Material Settings. Let's drag the isShell parameter into Shell Settings. There will be different options of operation depending on the cursor position. Make sure to drop it while pop-up is showing Insert into Panel. Then, add inputs. Shell Radius, Initial Mass, Shell Lifetime, Shell Lifetime Randomness, Shell Burst Speed, in that order. For the tail settings, add inputs in order of Tail End Radius, Tail Lifetime, Tail Lifetime Randomness, Tail Noise Gain, and lastly for material settings, add an order of Head Color, Tail Color, Head Emission Strength, Tail Emission Strength. We'll keep the seed and shell levels outside. Alright, now that everything is in order, let's take a look at some examples. With its long tail and circular shape, Kiku is a firework with long traditions. This version has three layers of stars with different colors, but even with single layer, Kiku is beautiful in the sky. Make sure to set different shell radius for a golden sphere, depending on layer. Use high value for tail lifetime to create a long, glorious tail. Just like Kiku, Botan's tradition goes way back. The difference is its tailless form. This example uses three layers with different radius also, but eliminates its tail by setting tail lifetime to zero. Luminosity drops due to lack of tail, so add more stars and increase head emission strength to compensate. Composition of two different types of stars with different tail lengths and speed creates this unique Mangekyo shape. This unique contrast is created by placing small amounts of high-speed stars with long tails on the outside, and placing high amount of low-speed stars with no tail on the inside. Wondering where the tail might lead to, Yanagi will keep you staring up at the sky. To make this, drop the shell burst speed of level 0 very low to almost make it into a free fall. For level 1, instead of using golden sphere, just add a mesh circle. Increase the shell lifetime and tail lifetime on level 1 to make this weeping willow. With first blast looking like a dud, people are often overjoyed when they are greeted with secondary blasts resembling bouquet of flowers. In parameter settings, make sure isShell for level 1 is true, and shell level for level 2 is set to 2. Nice timing variation is created by using high shell lifetime randomness for level 1. Simple shape firework example showing how any shape can turn into a beauty if launched in the sky. The shape is as simple as it can be. Three mesh circles with different angles on top of each other. After adding mesh circle, go into edit mode and duplicate. Then, rotate by 60 degrees on y-axis. That's all that it takes. When two different shapes and colors appear, you cannot help but recognize its contrast. You get Adam when you combine the concept of Mangekyo with Ren. Creating two layers with different shape is all it takes to make this. Yep, it's a monkey head. Though this is totally an original firework. Shaped firework resembling butterflies, hearts, and such exists. To make shaped firework, all it takes is to pass a mesh with that shape in Shell Builder. For this though, I separated them into three layers since I wanted to change colors for its eyes and mouth. Firework with this level of accuracy is only possible with computer graphics. For this, I added another helper function that turns string mesh into points. Simply combining to create new effects, it is amazing how much potential Geometry Notes has. This might be taking it too far, but it is fun to make a firework that you can only imagine of. Since you took a fair amount of time making this firework generator, I urge you to have fun with it. Alright, it's been a long journey of 10 video episodes. Thanks to all of you who have stuck with me till the end. Hope you enjoyed the series. If you have any questions or requests, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments. Thank you again, and hope to see you next time.